lung cancer is the second most common cancer across the U.S., and it remains a leading cause of cancer death. But there may be hope on the horizon for those with that tough-to-treat form of lung cancer. Joining us to discuss a new FDA-approved treatment this morning is Dr. Jason Port, an oncologist at West Cancer Center here in the Mid-South, and with him, Janet Freeman-Daily, the president of the Ross Wonders. Good morning, you guys.
Good morning. Thanks so much for having us.
Thank you guys for joining us. Well, for starters, Dr. Porter, I'd like to start with you. What is non-small cell lung cancer, and what does it mean to have a ROS1 positive diagnosis?
So non-small cell lung cancer is the most common type of lung cancer that we diagnose in patients. And to have a ROS1 positive non-small cell lung cancer means that patient had a biopsy, we diagnosed the lung cancer, and then we did biomarker testing to reveal an abnormal gene fusion called ROS1.
And then after that diagnosis, what is the next step?
The next step after we diagnose and do the biomarker testing is to take that patient to the appropriate treatment, or the treatment that's going to be most effective and give them the longest benefit. And so usually for patients who have ROS1 positive non-small cell lung cancer, they're younger patients. These patients often don't have a history of smoking, and also they're usually female patients.
Oh, that's interesting. So obviously there's been some progress against the disease. Can you tell us about the new treatment that the FDA has approved?
Right, so recently the FDA approved a therapy called Augtyro or repotrectinib for patients who have ROS1 positive non-small cell lung cancer. It's developed by Bristol Myers Squibb, with whom we're here today. And it's approved for patients with non-small cell lung cancer who are adults, where their disease has spread within their chest or to other parts of their body and is caused by the abnormal ROS1 gene. When we treat with this therapy, we can see side effects like dizziness, but each patient is unique. And so if you're on the therapy, it's really important that you talk to your doctor about any side effects that you may be experiencing. And we can learn more about the treatment at augtyro.com. That's augtyro.com.
Thank you for that fantastic information. Janet, of course, I want to bring you into this conversation. You are a cancer survivor and an advocate for patients, an amazing advocate at that. Why did you want to, and why was it important for you to co-found the Ross Wonders, and what exactly is it?
The Ross Wonders is a group of patients with either dealing with or have family members dealing with ROS1 positive cancer, and it's relatively rare. So it's really important for patients to be able to talk to each other. And new treatments like this are especially important for us because, as you mentioned, I'm a patient. And when I was diagnosed in 2011, about half of patients died within the first year. But thanks to biomarker testing and targeted therapies, patients are doing better. Cancer, however, is smart. It mutates and gets around these treatments. So getting new treatments available to us that help treat our type of cancer gives us more time with our families.
Absolutely. And Janet, also being able to create a community around you and to be able to talk to other cancer survivors and people going through the same things that you're going through, how important is be able to have that community around you? Just to be able to talk shop about it.
Being able to talk to somebody else who has the same disease as you do and is going through the same treatments is huge. Especially with such a rare cancer, it's really hard to find other people that understand what you're going through. You can find more information about this at our website, therosswonders.org. I'll spell that for you, THEROS1DERS.org. And we also have a Facebook group where people can talk to other people living with the same disease.
Yeah, and being an online advocate and being online just to be able to talk with other people in those dark days, I'm sure, is very important as well.
It very much is.
Your point of view on this new treatment, what do you think about this new FDA possibility, and what are your thoughts on it?
It's so important to have additional options because the cancer is able to mutate and get around treatments. It's nice to have another next option to be able to go to.
Oh, absolutely. And Dr. Porter, one last time for folks who want to get in contact with you regarding any treatment question that they may have, how would they be able to contact you?
So for the Octyro therapy, you want to go to augtyro.com. And of course, I'm at the West Cancer Center in Memphis.
Absolutely. Well, thank you guys so much, both of you, for your time this morning. Thank you.